I'm in VS Code, and I've already created a new .jl file. I've also launched the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. And I've adjusted my user interface so that my REPL window takes up roughly half of my screen. When constructing a tuple, you have the option of using a name for each element of that tuple. Doing so will construct something called a named tuple, meaning that each element of that tuple has a unique name associated with it. To access an element in a named tuple, you can use an index number just like you can with a tuple.
Boring!
Or you can use the name of the element by using the variable name for the named tuple, followed by a dot, then the element name. Depending on your data, it may be easier to refer to your data by name rather than using an index number. But like a tuple, a named tuple is immutable, so you can't change any of the element values, you can't sort it, and you can't change the size of the named tuple. With that said, both the tuple and the named tuple provide a memory-efficient way to store and retrieve your data if you don't need the flexibility of an array. So that's the basics of using a named tuple in Julia. In the next chapter, you'll learn what a dictionary is and how to use it in Julia.